Brandon Tillman.
Named Drake Coley.
Alana Thomas.
Wallace Quino.
Ulysses Delaney. I call him Yuli.
Clarence Gross.
Jasmine Gross.
It's see, it's weird being from it. You kind of like, kind of just like, it's an unspoken like cultural norm. It's an unspoken societal norm for us.
I don't think it's a big deal. I mean, I do think that some people are just doing it just to do it because it's a trend.
Okay, now this one's interesting.
Now, you being from African culture.
Yep.
Yeah, one thing I know, they're really strict on that.
They're very, very strict. I had my mom even come to me, like, because my mom, you know, she watches CNN a lot. And when Obama passed that bill saying homosexuals could marry, she was angry.
Growing up, I had a friend with a kid. My man, Larry from Reaction. You know about Reaction, man?
Yeah.
That was my man. Man was tight. He was undercover. That's what you call a guy who messed with a girl that he was secretly gay, we didn't know. Mm-hmm. That man was tight. He talked. And I had suspicions. Somebody was like, yo, your man gay? But that's impossible. It's my man. So basically, me being like stupid and so immature and not smart about it, some pictures came out one day. I was like 10, 11 grade high school. Pictures came out. He's kissing another guy. And I stopped talking. We stopped talking for years. I just apologized to him about like 2 months ago. We literally stopped talking.
Well, if you was talking about back in 1992 through 2006 or 7, maybe. But today I don't think is as big of a thing, especially amongst, like I said, amongst the newer generation. Mm-hmm. But if you talk to cats that came from 1980 or 1990, a certain generation, there's definitely homophobia there.
I feel like it is a big deal still to a lot of people, not to the post-millennials, but I feel like anybody born before 93 still has like that mindset of like homosexuality is taboo, like the homophobia is real serious.
Well, actually, the taboo far as guys like a guy, girls like a girl, the transgender, all that, first of all, that goes back to slavery. That's where the word, the MF word comes from. All that comes from that.
Right. She's not being a horrible person, but it's just the culture. Like, they don't come from that. You don't see homosexuality out in the open, like in the ancient African times and stuff. It just wasn't a thing.
I understand why people want to love somebody that's their same sex, because I've done it before. So, I mean, it's just you loving somebody. It's not really anything deeper than that, or like anything that you're really getting out of it. It's just love.
So I feel like the homophobia is still very strong in the Black community, but it's starting to fade. And I think it's starting with the post-millennials. They're starting to be more warming to it because they're starting to push it out there more as being normal and being accepted.
They're making it regular now. Back when I grew up, probably one gay dude in the hood, maybe one transsexual. They ain't messing with it. It was cool. Now, every other person, it's a fad. That shit is like enshrined in your brain now. You see it on TV all the time. One of the times you watch a show or movie, there wasn't no homophobic activity. You can't remember because it's propaganda. Now that's all you see.
Some people will do it because they want to be like Twitter or Instagram famous or something like that. They just want to have something to do, or they don't. Or like a guy doesn't love them, so they want to become a lesbian. Or, you know, a lot of gay guys don't have their father figure, so they feel like, you know, trying to run and find it. The same thing with a woman. They will still try and find a male figure to fill that void for them.
Like, yeah, man, okay, you'll see like one or two, you know, okay, whatever. It's just one or two. Now there's like a whole block of them.
I think it'll be looked at as more normal because, believe it or not, there's a lot of people who are homosexuals and they're just keeping it in because they know that if they say something, their grandma, their daddy, whoever in their family will disown them. There's a lot, there's still a lot of that going on in the black community.
We like trends. So I don't believe in the fact that the black community really don't like it. I just believe it's because it's called bandwagon effect. One person said they hate it, everyone in the community gonna say they don't like it. But I bet you money, if then nobody say anything, they will let them live their normal lives.
It's profitable now. So it's good to talk about it. Look at RuPaul's Drag Queen. Come on, man, that shit got 9 seasons.
RuPaul's Drag Race, yeah,
9 seasons. People love that shit. Like, it's profitable. It's okay to be transgender. Let's print on some some I Love Gay t-shirts, some headbands, and let's march. Men's all the business.
I don't think it's a trend. I think it's a movement. I think it's a movement that's probably going to carry on to the next generation. And the next generation is going to be more, people are going to be more open with it. I don't think it's a trend. I think it's going to continue.
Plus, the way I think about it, you have to try and figure out where that person's coming from and why they think the way that they do, why they do the things that they do. Because a lot of the time, no one tries to figure out what it is that's going on that causes anything to happen in their life like that. I don't think it should be at any point in time. I personally don't care. I can talk about anything, anywhere. I'm fine with that.
Because a lot of people still have the old mentality of it's not accepted or it's not normal, you're not born this way, how dare you? People being disowned by their family, being disowned by their friends, possibly being fired from their jobs because their boss is very conservative and doesn't believe in that. So I feel like people are still just scared to come out.
Yo, you can't glass over it anymore. That's all I know. You have to talk about it now. They put it out there. You have to talk about it. It's all over TV, you know, especially in our TV shows, Empire, Star. Okay, now Star is just oversaturated with, you know, LGBT stuff. It's everywhere now. You can't ignore it.
Yeah, I think they do, but I think they talk about it in a negative way all the time.
Like how?
Like, they'll say it's something in the water, or, like, you know, gay dudes are doing too much, and...
You know, if you want to sit there and talk about it, we can talk about it. I don't got no shame in that. But not everybody feels that way. So I guess if, you know... If being in a private setting makes them feel comfortable, then go ahead. If being at home makes you feel comfortable, go ahead and do that. Sitting in just a room with your friends, do that. That's how you feel comfortable. But not everyone feels that way, I guess.
I don't understand the transgender thing because it's just confusing to me. But I'm not gonna just say that I don't care about it or, you know, it's just gross. I'm trying to understand it, so I don't want to be that ignorant type of person, but I don't get it because I don't understand how you can be born a man and then like other men and then become a girl. So are you straight now?
I think the idea of it is being introduced to our children more than it used to be. It's being shown as an option, it's being shown as a normal, it's being normalized more so. It's more normalized than it is being seen as like an other.
Hell, no, it's on every TV show, right? You got kids. This little kid called me a bisexual. I'm gonna knock his ass out. He said, yo, you're a bisexual. What are you talking about? Oh, my friend's a bisexual. He's 8. He like men and women. But he's 8 years old. He ain't even got no pubic hair on his junk. How the fuck do you know what he like?
Forced on our children. I think it's confusing our children. I don't think it's forced on them. Like, a child will see two men kissing and they'll feel like, oh, okay, this is an option now.
Well, he sees it on TV a lot. He watches on cartoons. That shit is like enshrining. You understand? Kids are like vessels. Little kids. You put something in their head, they're gonna go away. So you got these kids, 5, 6 years old, watching these cartoons on Nickelodeon. A black dad and a white dad, and the kid's white. Oh, I got 2 dads. That thing is regular. I'm mad at a friend growing up, he had 2 moms. He wasn't proud about it.
You know what I mean? When it's just, because I don't believe you're born gay. I don't. That sounds ridiculous to me.
At the other time, I don't believe you're born straight either. We're babies. We don't have that kind of thinking yet. The homos hasn't kicked in.
I know. And
he's a joke gone too far.
Honestly, it's something that people were warned about.
I can't stand Donald Trump.
Being in office.
I really don't think it really matters who's in office. I think that the Congress makes all the decisions.
Oh, that's the ultimate hustler right there. He hustled his way into the White House, honey. I feel like he's the perfect person for them to put in office, because not for us, but for them.
To be honest with you, I don't have no words for that man, except our country is going to a deep, dark place. Because for a man who can talk to people on a feminist, sexist, and racist level and still get elected in the office, I'm not too mad at you. I'm not mad at Trump. I'm mad at those who let you in office, because all Trump did was let me know who is who.
He's not the first and last white guy to this, like, African-American race. He's not the first president. He's not the last president. He just, only thing with him, he open with it. And the dumb people still voted for a man who was open with it. So that's their fault.
Yeah, you know, it was funny when, you know, he was running for the Republicans, and now this dude's president. And I'm sitting here like, all you literally had to do was not vote for him if you didn't want him, especially in the primaries. That's all you literally had to do.
It's something that people were warned about. When you take a person who literally is just a mouthpiece, literally, he literally embodies what the title of president is. It's literally just a figurehead that the rest of the government will speak through. Hence why with the election we had, when you notice that most of Congress is now Republican, you wonder why the things we have are happening. We wonder why Trump got put into office. It's not by the popular vote. The popular vote doesn't mean anything. It's just who the people like.
He's just, oh my God. He's just a frustrating person. Okay. Donald Trump is ignorant. So I'm not even worried about Donald Trump, honestly. I do feel like his mouth is gonna get us in some deep shit, but it's not even him. It's the people who he has behind him. That vice president needs to get the fuck out of there.
We all know there's racism. There's people that don't like women. People are feminists about all that. We know this, but we didn't know who. Now, when I saw that and I saw how many states chose him, based off everything he said at all his rallies, that let me know, like, I can't even just hate you for being a person. You brought out the true character of everyone, almost a lot of people in this nation. So it ain't just you. I'm just upset with him because he's the face of this nation.
You heard about the surgeon couple who voted for him and he kicked their ass out?
Yeah.
That's they for. They were so fucked up, they didn't want a woman in office. They voted for a guy who don't like nobody. Because he grew up like that. Like, racism and shit don't come overnight, right? Some of that shit you taught, bro. Like, some of that you taught. I remember in the hood, we used to go white people crackers. Them crackers, turkey sandwiches from crackers. You taught that.
Like, oh, you wonder what we felt like? Like, it's funny. No one wanted to do all these marches and stuff. No one saw the importance of it until everybody started getting treated like black people in America.
And they tell the president what he can and can't do. He can make a suggestion for a bill to go past, but it's all about what Congress wants to go through and what they don't want to go through. Like if they don't want Trump to take away Obamacare, he can't take away Obamacare. He has to go through them.
Because they know he doesn't have the experience, but he has the money. He has a lot of money that could help them push a lot of things that they want to push. And since he doesn't have the experience, they don't have to do a lot of influencing to him to get him to do certain things, especially things that are the decisions that are based off of hate, like him doing this Muslim ban. I feel like
They just about to have their way.
Oddly enough, I say it's karma. Why do I say it's karma? Because the majority of the people in this country who use it are not black. The majority of the people who fraud it are not black.
I disagree with it. I mean, even though a lot of women don't really use it. I mean, a lot of black women don't really use it. But I'm against it because a woman should be able to do whatever she wants with her body.
Man, I don't even think he know what he's doing. Like, he's supposed to be president, but it's clear that he doesn't really know what he's doing or what he's trying to mess with. Like, Obamacare is going to kill a lot of people. If he gets rid of that, it's going to literally kill a lot of people. Planned Parenthood. If you get rid of that, you are literally going to have a lot of irresponsible people doing a lot of irresponsible stuff.
Honestly, they stupid because, first of all, people don't understand Obamacare. Obamacare was the ACA. It was already established. The only reason why they called it Obamacare is because he's a black president. And they, because of the fact that they want no one to know what it really was, they wanted people to hate President Obama more, they made the name Obamacare. Everything that people have been using has been the same. They just added a label to it.
He's not the first person that did that. Is he the first?
No.
Is he going to be the last? No. Get up off your ass, man. Work. Educate yourself.
Okay. So how do you, speaking of that, how do you feel about the pen trying to get rid of Obamacare and Planned Parenthood?
Obamacare has its issues. Obamacare has its issues. I mean, I heard that he was trying to replace it with something else. That's what I heard. And if what he was replacing, what he was going to replace it with is better than Obamacare, then that's great. That's groovy. But if he's just trying to get rid of free healthcare or government funded healthcare altogether, mm-hmm. then I don't agree with that.
The Obamacare thing, all they're going to do is take Obama's name off of it and put their name on it. It's basically going to be the exact same thing, but they're not about to let this black man have this legacy of creating this great thing that helps the country. So they're going to take his name off of it and put their own spin on it and have it as their own from now on. That's how I feel about the Obamacare. The Planned Parenthood, I really, really, really think that that's not going to be a good idea. I don't agree with it at all. Because you'll never see a room full of 6 or 7 women making decisions on men's genitals, ever. You're never going to see that, ever.
Well, honestly, the change is already happening. It is, in big numbers. It's happening rapidly, too. It's like it was a quick switch from, let me do my thing, to, A, how can we help each other? It was real quick.
We gotta love each other more, honestly. It's just, we gotta stop being so angry and so offensive and so defensive. We just, like, we have to just chill out.
Go to Africa. Like, find out where you came from. Reconnect with your ancestors. Reconnect with your home. Come back home.
More growth, building, more love. I would like to be able to walk outside and see the next door neighbor walk into the next door neighbor, and them two next door neighbors walk into the next door neighbor and being like, what do you need help with? What can we help you with? What can we build? What can we do to help our kids? Can we build better schools? Can we get better teachers? Because in the hood, they don't teach. They build it to where kids are graduating from high school with no dreams, no hopes nowadays.
We gotta educate ourselves, man. I gotta tell you, Ray, change not gonna come, man, so you need to educate yourself, man. Like, how you gonna know how to build a house, man, if you don't know how? If you don't know what the foundation is. You know what I'm saying? So we gotta educate ourselves, man.
Well, I would like to see the black community, I would like to see them be more open-minded. Black people, especially in the past, have been very closed-minded. It's like they're a hive mind.
What I say to every black person that ever watches this, like, find out where you come from. Because Africa will welcome you with open arms.
I like to see them expand their minds and expand all together. Like, for example, like, when you see white people, there's a whole bunch of different ways to be white. You can be, like, a businessman, very professional life. You can be a punk rocker, you can be emo, goth, you can be a skateboarder type of dude, surfer. And those are all valid ways to be white. I mean, some of more accepted than others. Mm-hmm. But no one's gonna say, oh, you're not white.
I just like to see more growth. More growth. I feel like we do need to go back to our roots. It's not that hard to find out where you came from.
Back in my, one thing I realized is this, back in my grandparents' day, they used to have 13 kids. And when my mom was born, she had kids, they couldn't even get, make past five. Now my generation makes it to the point where marriage is going obsolete. Kids, is, it ain't even about getting married and having kids. It's all about baby mamas and baby fathers, all deadbeats. Our generation is destroying it. And our community need to rebuild it. Our community needs to bring that back, that family loving back.
America doesn't have to be the only place that you can call your home. You have a whole continent full of people that look like you. Find yourself, man.
And we need to realize that, you know, this ain't gonna be a cakewalk. Shit's gonna have to get done, and we're gonna have to do things that we're not comfortable with doing. Like, I'm sure Martin Luther King didn't want to get up every day and march. He wouldn't stay in his bed and chill, but he had to make a change. So I think us as Black people, especially because we're the main, like, we're the most talked about thing right now. So I feel like us as a community, us as a group, should come together and do what we have to do to make a change, whether it be violent, sleep, or something peaceful, or making like petitions or something. We have to do something.
We have so much control of the world, so much influence over the world, we don't even know it. Because you don't care to know it. Because it's not popping. It's not, you think about black people, some black people want things easy. Sometimes I do, I'm not gonna lie. But it's not gonna be like that. You gotta read and educate yourself, man. The community, the hood always gonna be there. Black people gonna be there. We gotta educate ourselves. We gotta come together. We gotta build, bro. We need black businesses, man. Like, we need, like, I'm talking about real businesses. Like, all these black girls buying all this hair, but don't know black, ain't no black hair company. I don't understand that. We're the number one consumer. But we'll put money in these Caucasian people's pockets and these Asians and these Iranians, but we don't put money in our own pocket.
A lot of the popular YouTubers, they're doing the ancestry where they're finding out where they're from. So I feel like more people should be influenced to do that so that we can have more of a grounds of who we are, where we came from, what we should do to expand and be the leaders that we're meant to be.
Because until we bring that family loving back, we are just going to be black people who live in the same area.
Aha!